Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. I don't do reaction videos anymore, mainly because I feel like people on YouTube are over it. However, I do have a separate Facebook account where people would love reaction videos. So today I want to share a few of my more recent reactions that you'll see over on Facebook, along with some kind of like exclusive Facebook only content over there. I'll link it in the description box down below. Do let me know if you're into these kind of reactions and just kind of like seeing this kind of stuff together. And maybe I'll bring it back to this channel here, but yes, please enjoy what is usually Facebook exclusive content here. Okay, first video. This is why we need to do DIY. First of all, this is a apple cider vinegar, lemon juice, and honey. It looks like she has in there. I don't think she's written it, but it's made this kind of like, almost like natural waxy thing. So bad. I'm not laughing because I think it's funny. It's just awful. The thing is with a lot of DIY recipes is they do require you to heat something up in the microwave quick, add boiling water, and of course, you can't put that on your skin. That is gonna scald your skin. This looks like it's got honey in. That natural like honey texture is very, very familiar in DIY recipes. So if you wanted to use this as a mask, you can't even really let it cool because it's gonna set. But also in here we have apple cider vinegar, which you shouldn't apply directly onto the skin. It works as almost like an exfoliant, but not as good. It can really irritate your skin. Lemon juice, you should never put on your skin. This can blister your skin, it can burn. The moment you step out in the sun, it can still blister your skin. Sugar is honestly not too bad, just be careful when you're scrubbing, but usually when you add water to sugar, it's going to dissolve. So it's not the harshest of scrubs, but still absolutely nothing I would ever do. Honey is actually, you're good to go with putting honey on your face. It can be nicely soothing, calming. If you leave on your face for like 10 minutes, like a mask, it can help calm down acne. It can help soothe inflammation. Honey really is one of the only things that I'm like okay with in DIY recipes.
Short-term Botox. Look, hydration, tightening pores, lifting. Leave 10 minutes and take a good shower after.
So these egg masks, here's why they are short-term Botox. First of all, nothing beats Botox. Just get Botox if you want the effects of Botox. You save so much more money in the long run instead of having to buy eggs after eggs after eggs. Second of all, these only work because the egg is drying out on your skin. And what this does is it does temporarily like kind of like pull the skin tight. So it can even out some wrinkles, fine lines, even a bit of puffiness. But egg whites can also be very drying as well. When formulated into a product, they can be beneficial for your skin, but there's no reason to put raw egg on your face like this really. It's just drying down.
Only wash your skin at night. Double cleanse, no morning wash, only at night before bed, 1 hour before bed.
That's interesting. I've never heard anyone say an exact time to wash your face before bed. What I think is more important is say the time you put on a moisturizer compared to when you go to bed. You know, it is kind of nice to let your products sink into the skin, do what they need to do on the skin before hitting the pillow. So I don't really think you need to time when you wash your face in the evening. Not washing your face in the morning, it became kind of like a skincare trend, and it is really beneficial for some people. If you have dry skin, if your skin's irritated, then there really is no need to do anything that other than splash your face with water or use a micellar water on your face, then go in with your other products in the morning. If you're oily or if you apply heavy products like heavy creams, occlusives, if you're slugging in the evening, you would want to wash your face in the morning to wash all that off. Especially in the summer when you're sweaty, you want to get that all off your face in the morning. So interesting, completely depends though. We have some no makeup beauty hacks here, so let's have a look.
5 tricks I use to look and feel a little bit cuter without makeup. My first trick is to get a lash lift. A lash lift is a perm that keeps your lashes lifted. I also get them tinted, so they are lifted and tinted without any mascara. Tip 2 is to whiten your teeth. I love Crest white strips. I've never had to go get my teeth professionally whitened. If you do these like once every 2 weeks, your teeth are gonna
be white. I love
that. Tip number 3 I learned at photo shoots, and that's to use your lip balm as a highlighter. If you're going for like a really natural glow or you don't want to wear much makeup that day, you can use a lip balm or even a face oil as a nice little highlight for your cheekbones for added glow and hydration. Tip number 4 is eye masks. Pop these babies on as you're getting ready to leave, and your under eyes are gonna be a little bit more bright and plump before you leave the house. Tip is my favorite no makeup secret, and that's to use a fake tan. Use a dot of your fake tan on your makeup brush to do your contour. When you wash your face, you're left with a natural contour with no makeup. You can get in the ocean, you could go swimming, and your contour is gonna stay all day.
This sounds so bland and boring, but Vaseline, Aquaphor, whatever version of that kind of petroleum-based product you want to use, is really one of the key staples to have. Like this lady said, it can provide a really nice natural highlight or natural glow to your skin. One thing I used to do when I worked for a lot of retail companies and did a lot of photo shoots and stuff, I would used to have to put Vaseline on my lips, but also on my teeth. Because when I was doing a photo shoot, you'd be like fake smiling all day. That sometimes your teeth and lips will get dry. So when you smile, you get like stuck like this. So the Vaseline allowed some slip. Crest whitening strips are the only whitening strips I would ever use. And I feel like they're not really approved by dentists, but I have had professional teeth whitening here in the UK that was nothing compared to what Crest whitening strips did for my teeth. I use a pack of like 10, 20, maybe once a year, and my teeth are kind of like absolutely fine. I've never had any sensitivity. Speak to your dentist though, not me. Eye masks and eye creams are something that I never really used to care about until I hit 30. And then I was like, I need to do something about my eyes. These eye patches are great, but what's even better are the silicone ones that you can buy, reusable ones, because they work with your serums and moisturizers, and you can leave them on for however long you like without them drying down. And when you take them off, you see a visible difference. Temporary effects at first when it comes to smoothing fine lines, but they really, really can de-puff under the eyes as well. And the longer you use them for, the better your results are gonna be, the better your permanent results are gonna be. I can already tell I'm gonna hate this one. This looks like baking soda.
So I wash my face with baking soda and water. I just kind of mix up a paste and I just kind of use it to like scrub on, because baking soda is really good for brightening your skin, getting those like acne scars lightened. If you want, you can leave it on for a few minutes for like a kind of like a brightening skin mask, because it's supposed to like lighten up dark spots. I'm not dunking my face in ice water today, but I'm gonna take an ice cube and I'm just gonna rub it all over it, like my face and my neck. I mean, it's pretty much the same thing, if almost not a little bit more potent, because I've actually gotten brain freezes doing this. Oh, there it goes. Apple cider vinegar as a toner. What? This dry oil from Merle Norman to start my lymphatic draining massage, which I will go into full detail for you later. It drains everything, gets puffiness away.
I didn't realize it was gonna go on like that. Baking soda on your face, absolutely no. Do not do this. When formulated into a product, it can help control sebum production, your natural oils. It can help even out skin tone in some cases. When you take this out of a packet and mix it with water yourself and put it in your face, it's extremely, extremely damaging for your skin. People use baking soda to clean things, to unclog drains in this form when it's formulated like this. You can tell I don't do housework. Is it unclog drains? I don't know. But what this does is dries your skin out so much and can irritate your skin so much, and it can destroy your skin barrier, which in the long run is going to lead to more breakouts. It's going to lead to your face looking red, inflamed, itchy. It really is a no-win situation with this, and you get very obvious instant results with baking powder, baking soda masks, but the long run, the damage it's going to do, the drying that's going to do to your skin, it's not worth it. It's really not. Apple cider vinegar, again, is a natural AHA. But here's the thing with natural alternatives to skincare. First of all, you don't know what dose you're getting. It could be too high, it could be too low, because it's natural the way things grow. It's not always an exact science as to how much of that active ingredient is in that natural product. Apple cider vinegar is very high in acids, so it's gonna, again, completely dry down your skin, irritate it. You can get burns from apple cider vinegar. You can put it on your skin if you want to, just dilute it. Ice on the face. No. The fact that she said she was getting brain freeze means she was keeping it in one area for too long. You can really damage your skin with prolonged contact to ice on your face. Redness, flushing, irritation again. Yes, dunking your face in ice or applying a cold compress to your face will temporarily make your face look smoother, poreless almost. But again, within half an hour, you're going to be back to normal. There is no benefit, long-term benefit, to rubbing an ice cube on your face. Okay, this lady's going to share some of her skincare secrets with us.
I have really good skin, and this is my secret. For the last 7 years, I have been using facial oils. Using a face oil every night locks in moisture and prevents your face from getting dry. You literally should be looking like a glazed donut every night. I promise you it works. This is a list of my favorite oils. The Youth to the People Prickly Pear is amazing for acne-prone skin. The Biossance Squalane and Rose Oil is what I personally use, and I have also used the Drunk Elephant Marula Oil. 10/10 recommend.
She does have amazing skin, and it's really nice to see someone just admit that. Give themselves a compliment, you know? So here's the thing with oils. Yes, they're great. They're nice to use. I personally don't use them as an oily person because I don't want to feel more oily. Not all oils are occlusives. What an occlusive is just a layer on your skin. The idea being that water cannot escape your skin, keeping your skin nicely hydrated, especially overnight where we lose the vast amount of hydration from our skin. However, not all oils can do this. Not all oils act as a barrier. The ones she's listed are actually occlusive barriers. They work great. And it's a great thing to do if you want to lock in hydration and wake up feeling dewy. In the long term, can help reduce fine lines and wrinkles. However, I would just use Vaseline. It's a guaranteed barrier. You don't have to do your research and mess around with oils if you don't like them. Good old Vaseline doesn't clog your pores. It's not bad for you despite what the internet tells you. Just, yeah, if you want a more affordable option. But yeah, if you want oils, marula, jojoba, lanolin, and even olive oil, but just buy Vaseline. There we go. I hope you enjoyed that. As I mentioned, you can check out more reaction style content over on my Facebook. I'll leave that in the description down below. But that's it for me now. You can watch some more reaction videos here, I guess, and some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.